you might suspect somebody is using of your Wi-Fi. Perhaps you accidentally shared the password, or perhaps your internet connection is running slower than usual. Here's a foolproof method for identifying Wi-Fi theft. If your internet connection seems to be moving more slowly than usual, you might believe someone is hogging your Wi-Fi bandwidth. Slow internet, however, is not proof. There may be a number of additional factors at play in your slow connection. A list of connected devices on your router or Wi-Fi access points interface is the only certain way to determine if someone is accessing your Wi-Fi. For instructions on how to access the router's configuration interface, refer to your router's documentation. The majority of consumer routers offer access via a web browser at a unique, local-only address such as 0.1 or 192.168.1.1, and some even offer access via mobile apps. Let's connect to the router. Now write the username and password. You can find this usually on the back of your router. After you logged in, we must locate where your router lists the devices connected to your Wi-Fi network. This is frequently accessible by selecting status, wireless status, or traffic control, among other possibilities. The process for locating the list of connected devices may differ significantly amongst router suppliers because there is no industry standard router interface. For me, the connected devices on the router are found on clients. You will see a list of Wi-Fi devices connected to your network once you are on the wireless connection status screen of your router. In the list of devices, keep an eye out for unexpected names. Any devices with odd names that you notice could be those that your neighbors are using to connect to your Wi-Fi network. You need to eliminate any of your own devices from that list in order to be certain. You may have more Wi-Fi clients than you think between smart TVs, game consoles, streaming devices, smart home appliances, tablets, smartphones, and more. When you first see them all listed out, it can be a little unexpected. Also, keep in mind that not all of your permitted Wi-Fi devices will have names that are immediately evident. Some may instead be presented as MAC addresses. If you have many Wi-Fi clients, it may take some time to determine if a particular item on the list is yours or not by comparing the MAC addresses of the devices you own with those on the list. Additionally, for privacy purposes, some of your devices might provide fresh, random MAC addresses, which might make this matching procedure more challenging. You might wish to take screenshots of your router's wireless device connection list, paying close attention to MAC addresses, in case anything unlawful or harmful occurred as a result of your neighbor utilizing your Wi-Fi. If it proves useful later, this might offer some evidence that the connection actually occurred. What you can do to prevent somebody using your Wi-Fi. Update or add a password. You should typically update your Wi-Fi password and restart your router as soon as possible. All of your Wi-Fi devices must be configured with the new password before they can reconnect. Lock down your router and stop offering an open access point if you weren't using a password in the first place. Temporary block or ban. Using MAC address filtering, many routers enable blocking of devices. Some even let you block devices directly from the attached devices list. Since MAC devices can be faked and some devices purposefully modify their MAC addresses to avoid being clearly identified, this isn't foolproof. This should only be a temporary fix while you protect your Wi-Fi access point, if you choose to do it. These are some ways you can increase your security for your router. Thank you for watching this. If this was useful, please like, share, and subscribe. You can watch more videos from the right. If you have any questions, please ask them in the comments area below.